First of all, I would like to know the medium of communication that would be easier for you to understand, English or Hindi. Because I'm sorry, I can't speak Marathi well. First of all, I would like to thank Ramesh sir who has given us the opportunity to be here with you. And Hemant sir has conducted the lecture on the cashless transaction. Being very young, I am also not very well aware of the technology. I learned how to use Android phones to my students because I myself am a teacher. Today, I had started a couple of years back a spoken English literacy mission, which now the government is also starting. What was the name of the course, sir?
Success.
Success of the course. Because, see, sir has told about the technology. When we were, since our students' life or childhood, we read many books, we come to know about the various concepts and abstract ideas through various books like history, civics, geography, and come to know about various things that are happening all around the world. But how did we come to know about what's happening in Russia, what's happening in Germany, what's happening in Spain, America, in India? How are we come to know about this?
Newspapers.
The first answer is being discussed in our first lecture, that is to technology. And the second one is the medium of communication. We do not know German, we do not know the major driving force जिसने मुझे इस चीज़ के लिए force किया कि मैं spoken English literacy mission को launch करूँ वो ये था, बहुत सारे जब हम PDMs लेते थे, बहुत सारे PDMs हम जब लेते थे तो वहाँ पे मदर हमें कंप्लेन करती थी कि हमारे उनके बच्चे हमको कहते हैं कि आप PDM में मत आइए क्योंकि आप इंग्लिश नहीं बोल पाते हैं। तो सोचिए वो पेन उस मदर के अंदर क्या फील होता होगा जब उनके ही बच्चे उन्हें कह रहे हैं कि आप हमारे मीडियम में नहीं आ रहे। सो दिस वाज द प्राइमरी फोर्स दैट इनिशिएटेड मी टू टेक द कॉज। सो वी हैव स्टार्टेड द स्पोकन इंग्लिश लिटरेसी मिशन। नाउ इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट मीडियम ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन इन द होल वर्ल्ड द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट कम्युनिकेशन। वी ऑल नो दैट द इंग्लिश इज द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट मीडियम ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन इन द होल वर्ल्ड। अग्रीड और डिसएग्रीड?
Agreed.
We are having certain techniques and tricks to make the mothers and the students to understand. For example, I'll just give you a simple example. जब मैं महाराष्ट्र आया था तो बहुत सारे पाव मैंने सुने, like samosa pav, vada pav, pav bhaji, you know. And I am a very slow learner. I was a very bad student in my student life. I always used to try the tricks to understand the jokes. क्योंकि learning के बस की बात आज भी नहीं है। Sir, let me do lectures to you. I would like to share one more thing that Hemant sir was my teacher in my during my college days. So I've learned many a things and he plays a very important role in my life क्योंकि एक तो वो teacher है और दूसरे technology के teacher, तो दोनों पे I was very bad. अब एक पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच मैक्सिमम ग्रामर के टीचर जो हैं आई हैव वेरी डीपली रिस्पेक्ट फॉर ऑल द टीचर्स। पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच क्या है, क्या कोई बताएगा मुझे? फ्रॉम वेयर द ग्रामर स्टार्ट्स, सब्जेक्ट इज प्रेडिकेट, पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच।
There are eight parts of speech in English grammar: noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection.
Bless all your students. बहुत lucky होंगे आपके students. ये parts of speech जो है ये हर किसी को याद नहीं होती है. But अभी जो madam ने बोला ये सारे हम जानते हैं, right? यहाँ से ही ग्रामर स्टार्ट होता है। एज द ऑल द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स इन द होल वर्ल्ड आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू मेल्स एंड फीमेल्स, सिमिलरली ऑल द वर्ड्स यूज्ड इन द इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू इन दीज एट पार्ट्स, दैट इज द नाउन, प्रोनाउन, एडजेक्टिव, वर्ब, एडजेक्टिव, एडवर्ब, प्रेपोजिशन, इंटरजेक्शन एंड कंजंक्शन, राइट? स्टिल आई फॉरगेट सम. सो जब मुझे पाव पता चला तो मैंने हर वर्ड से हर वर्ड का पहला लेटर निकाला, लाइक प्रोनाउन का पी, नाउन का एन, एडजेक्टिव का ए. तो उससे मुझे मिला एन पी ए वी आई ए पी पी, राइट. सो आई हैव रीअरेंज दोज लेटर्स एंड डिराइव अनदर पाव, दैट इज अ पैनिक पाव, P A N I C and P A D, which is very easy for any student or anyone to understand and learn and memorize the thing that P stands for pronoun, A stands for adjective, N for noun, interjection, conjunction, preposition, adverb and verb. So in this way, I try to make the grammar very easy. And similarly, the second thing which is very important to us is speak in English, that is the tense, the use of right tense, the use of the right words and the right tense. So this is what we give in our 3 month course. Parts, after parts of speech and tenses ready, the people are very, it will be very easy for them to speak in English then. The third major important thing, I don't know how many of you insist your students to use lexicon. Lexicon is the second name for the dictionary, it's a synonym for dictionary. So how many of you inspire your student to use dictionary? Of course, ma'am, I understood. Even in your chemistry and physics, we come across many a words which students don't know the meanings of. So I insist that please initiate or ask the student to take initiative to use dictionary, because this is very important. Suppose if we are even the book of French and German, I don't think so we will read it with that incense or that